Hi, I'm Jason Debly, and tonight's whiskey review is a single malt whiskey, not from Scotland, but from Ireland, and specifically from the Bushmills distillery. Now, this bottle has been tapped by me and a couple of my buddies, and so I think I'm qualified now to tell you what I think of it. We can start with, besides being a single malt, basically what the Bushmills distillery has done, 40% alcohol by volume. I think there is chill filtration. This is a Diageo product. What Bushmills have done, they launched this a couple of years ago, I think in 2022, and now it's a permanent part of the Bushmills product lineup. They take two single malts, two spirits, age them separately in bourbon and oloroso sherry casks. I think they combine them. And then they finish them. Finish is a fancy word for a short-term aging in a further wood, a third wood, hence triple wood. And that would be Marsala wine casks, which is a Sicilian wine, fortified wine, which is usually used for cooking, not too great on its own, can be very sweet, can be dry, depending on what you get. And so this runs around in Canada, $60 a bottle. So it's not super expensive for a 12-year-old age statement in the whiskey category, although it's Irish whiskey, so that's a bit higher than, say, in Scotland. Scotch whiskey tends to be a little more pricey. Oh, I've poured some, so I'm ready to go. Let's nose this. Nose is not offensive in any way. I'm thinking copper pennies. Something darker than honey, caramel. It's good, not incredible, but not bad. Let's give it a sip here. Classic Bushmills style whiskey. The flavors don't last long, so the finish is quite short. I gotta do it again. I mean, like, it comes and it's gone. You know, it's really quick. Honey, oat, biscuits, a little bit of sugar donut, cake bread. They say it's aged in oloroso sherry casks. There's not a lot of oloroso influence. As for the Sicilian fortified wine, might be contributing some nutmeg and brown sugar. Let's take another sip. Like, the flavors flash past your palate. Like, you're driving on the highway, you see a Ferrari behind you, then you look back to look forward, and it's gone by. You know, that happened to me one time as I putt-putted along in my 92 Pontiac Bonneville outside Toronto. Honey melon. A little bit of peppermint on the finish. Very smooth, very approachable. It was popular. My friends liked it. We were drinking it this summer. It's one of many bottles, and had it with, I do recall at certain times drinking this with ice. You know, some people think you shouldn't drink whiskey with ice. I don't give a damn. It worked well with ice, and it works well neat. Is it incredible? No. Is it complex? No. Is it in any way bitter or offensive? No. It hits all the right notes. It's not fancy whiskey. It's better than their bottom shelf white label. There's no real heat to it, but can't say I'd probably buy another bottle. Not bad. If I saw it on a shelf and I was at a party or whatever, I would drink it, but Not gonna say I would get the Bushmills 12-year-old single malt again, which is triple wood. I think I'd pass. Not horrible. If I had to give it a numeric score, which I never do, but there was a viewer saying, Jason, you never give a numeric score. 1 out of 10, I'd give it a 7.5. It's a steady eddy, but it's not gonna light up your life. Okay, thanks for tuning in. I'm gonna try to pop out a couple other reviews tonight. Take care.